pray for the players, we hollowed the walls, I'm back at bodegas,
I got plenty, it's so many, yeah, they say gimme, he got plenty, yeah.
Bruh, you niggas ain't flexing, you cramping, my weight keeping niggas on the bikes like Amblin. Weight loss, rent loss, scrambling. Now pass the champagne to the champion. My niggas get money, get money, get money. Like Ye sampling.
All packed up. Well, I'm gonna throw a couple more things in there, but nice and neat. Did you get me? Also, these sheets are so fucking ugly. Like, I forgot to mention, this shit is so ugly. Look at the amount of water. That's a 2.5 gallon, 1 gallon, and then refilling my water bottles. That's a wrap. I'm gonna go get some donuts and maybe some coffee and like a sandwich or something to keep me over for the train ride to Seattle. And we'll come back and check out.
Rocking the same fit. This is comfortable and this is what I'm gonna wear on the train and on the plane back.
It's actually mad quiet right now. Just like sounds of Portland type beat.
Been to Blue Star, I've been to Voodoo. NOLA is talked about, so let's check it out.
NOLA donuts, I mean, they're donuts. What was most interesting is definitely the beignets. They're made to order. I think Blue Star is still my favorite of the three. Like the lemon poppy seed, I did not expect blue, like raspberry jam inside. That was like overkill. Yeah, like I feel like garbage right now. I don't even think I said where I'm going, but I'm going to a bakery and getting a sandwich and coffee. Jesus, that was like a 20 minute wait, god damn it. I gotta haul ass to get back to the hotel and check out and head to the train station.
We're drinking, my friend, to the end of a brief episode.
Alright, we're in Seattle now. I just need to get my ass to my friend's place so I can drop off my shit. Later,
I was there for like four nights.
They're gonna die. We was out in Brambleton after Pooh got hit. Club Entourage in that new drop six.
We are going to get some proper katsu right now. Man's is starving. All right, change of plans. We're at a different Japanese restaurant. Go crazy. What is that green stuff?
What is that green stuff? Cilantro pesto.
Oh yeah? That's good. Jesus. See this thing, yo? The uni on the wagyu, that bite. Come on now. I was waiting for my brother to watch it because he's like, I didn't finish the season yet, but apparently you don't need to watch like the. All right, we just wrapped up dinner. Let's talk about dinner. That was a pleasant surprise. They actually had proper seafood there, and for the price point, I'm very satisfied with the experience, like all in all. Right now, I'm at the homie's lounge in the complex. Here, I'll show you guys. So, oh, this beer, it's actually on tap. There's like a little movie room. Just look at this thing. Benches, more seating over there. We have this whole outdoor area. I'm gonna go outside in a second to boof it up. What is this, shuffleboard or something? I forget what it's called. Just a sick space. Like, he said he threw parties here, like, and had 40 people. You could probably fit like 60 people in here easily. These are like storage cubbies, like, his is right here, the 1800, the Truly, got the Jaeger up there. Just a vibe, bro. Bro, this thing is dangerous, yo. Hella foam. Can't record and pour. Yeah, that's too much fucking foam. Jesus Christ. God damn it, I hate when they set it to 720. I need my shit at 1080, you feel me? Alright, look at this, okay? Look at this. This in the summer, bro? Like, what's... Oh my god, come on now. If you want to do some tanning, just chill here. And tables, 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 tables. Two, count them, two grills. This is my third glass, by the way. Man's is sauced. That's a nice view. Come on now.
All right, J-Lo's busy with work, so I'm heading out to a coffee shop, gonna hit some stores, hit that Katsu spot, you feel me? And then we'll link back up later in the evening when he's like finished with work.
All right, the area I'm staying in is called Ballard. Ballard. It's very like residential and homey, so I get why he like lives over here. Yo, but let's talk about yesterday, the Oscars. Will Smith smacking the shit out of Chris Rock, bro. What? I feel like I didn't talk much yesterday, so let's talk about it. I was kind of a little disappointed that like I had to kind of sidebar the Katsu place because I really wanted to go there, but that other Japanese spot was, it redeemed, you know, the situation. I don't know, that's just kind of how it works, you know, when you're with other people, you kind of have to accommodate the group. But today I'm definitely gonna hit it. I'm gonna hit a couple stores that were recommended to me by Karsten, and it's just gonna be a chill day. More cherry blossoms. This coffee shop I'm going to is nothing special. I did like a quick little dig, and most of the coffee shops are like very homogenous. There's nothing unique that would draw me to them. So this one's in the area, and J-Lo recommended it. Says they got good coffee, so we'll just post up here for a little bit. That was kind of whatever. That pastry was hella mid because they didn't heat it up, so it was like kind of like, it wasn't flaky, it was cold, like eh. The single origin Nicaragua, I think that's how it's pronounced, that region or that origin or whatever, that was decent drip coffee. So this store apparently carries a lot of denim, carries Visvim. No expectations, just gonna go in, see what they got. Check out the ambiance and the decor and soak it all in. This place is kind of tucked away because this is like a little trail. I'm assuming that's it right there. The shop? Never mind, I think this one is it because I'm seeing jeans. Yep, there we go. Blue Owl. All right, here's the bell. I could not find it.
Vintage mall.
Oh yeah.
And but
that was Blue Owl. I was just chopping it up with the sales associate. Tried on a pair of Skagways. Didn't even know I needed a pair of those, but definitely a prospective purchase for sure. I am pretty fucking annoyed right now because the Katsu place is closed. It was literally, you know, right there in my hands. could have went yesterday and didn't because had to accommodate other people. Like, the table at the Katsu place was ready before we got seated at the second place. Like, come on now. Every good restaurant, every good Japanese restaurant is closed on Monday for whatever reason. This was literally my only objective for this entire trip. I've been looking forward to this place for weeks, and my whole mood has turned sour. Let's talk about it. That udon place was fucking mid, fucking trash actually. The wait time, all the hype built up, just trash. The whole day just went to shit after I found out the Katsu place is closed. Now I'm just trying to salvage what's left of today. And it is so nasty out. I'm going to Glasswing. This is like another, this is a boutique. I don't remember what brands they carry, but we'll find out right now. That shop was, the shopping here has been very mid, very almost abysmal. This place, the only thing worth looking at is Capital, and if you're not into Capital, I wouldn't even bother coming. That was Bogey Boys. There's supposed to be a vintage shop underneath, but they moved it. I literally just saw Macklemore because he's the one that started the store. Not sure if that's anything to celebrate. I don't listen to his music or anything. I feel like all I've been doing today is complaining, but I think it's justified. I mean, I'm just taking like some random ass L's on the last day too. The vibes are just off today. I swear to God, when I have a bad day, it's like the worst possible day. I didn't even mention, but I emailed my professor and was like, yeah, I'm not gonna be able to make the first class. But I called her by her first name and she emailed me back and was like, it's Dr. Pyra. And I'm like, ah. Fuck, you know? I've never seen a layout like this.
chicken teriyaki.
I just might do a chirashi sauce.
Chirashi.
Rice demon, extra dry.
Thank you, kind sir.
Gambay.
Gambay.
Oh my god, miso soup!
Which, to be fair, and now I got like a global health exposure as well. I'm just kind of like turned away from it.
Just going straight for the protein today?
A little rice.
Just protein today?
And some rice and some sake. Rice.
Yeah.
To make it again. Oh, they give you brown rice.
No soy for me. There's like a learning curve and you have to explain everything.
Right. And so.
No spoilers. What do you think of the movie? And then give a rating out of 10.
Okay. Utah looks like Aaron Yeager.
Okay.
8 out of 10.
8 out of 10. I think I'm up there too, 8 out of 10.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was a good movie.
It's quick.
Yeah. It was very quick, like good quick pace, snappy. Yeah. Yeah.
Good music.
Yeah.
Scenes are always crisp, of course.
Just keeps you like engaged, right? Locked in. And then the Batman movie?
Batman movie.
Out of 10?
7 out of 10.
7 max.
Yeah, 7 max.
Why? What was the one without spoiling? I feel like everyone's watched it though by now.
Yeah, acting mediocre.
Yeah.
The lines.
Corny.
Really corny.
Yeah.
And then cinematography and like action scenes were good.
Those were good.
They put a lot of effort into producing.
Did it bother you, the build up to the kiss?
I
didn't even like remember that part.
No. Plot was pretty long, but
for no reason.
You think it's no reason, but I think it was okay. It's like it's
the 3 hours is warranted.
But it's like the Riddler. You have to think about it. Like that's a classic. Like he has multiple plots thrown.
Did you like how they like his like attire? Did he look like the Riddler, or did he look like that scarecrow guy? You know what I'm talking about?
Oh.
I feel like this time he just didn't look like the Riddler.
Yeah, but I think they try to have a more modern take on like the Batman universe.
Yeah.
So I don't think a normal guy would wear a green top hat and a green suit. Like he just looked like a fucking psycho. And,
fair. That's fair.
You know what I mean? Like, don't try to like sell me like, oh, no carcinogen, and you're breathing in metals.
Pack that in with coffee, and like I'm zoned in.
Yeah, you're wired.
I'm in pretty good state too. What I actually am trying to convey, maybe I don't. Will not escape my ears.
I wonder how clean these things are.
It is probably my ego talking.
I didn't get a chance to talk about the restaurant, but that was really good. Very cozy, very homey. I'm exhausted. I'm gonna knock out now.
Here we are going on another side quest. I was gonna go to this place called Papa Chango yesterday, but they were closed. I think they're open today. It says open. I'm gonna get one of their little meat pies or like beef patties or whatever the fuck it's called. And this thing is like tiny. Look at this. I like it. It's very, he was just mixing it, like, it's not, it's balanced, you know?
Yeah, it doesn't have that bite that espresso does.
Yeah, but it's not, like, drowned in sugar.
Oh, yeah.
I just scraped it off the top, cut it off the roll, off the curve, off the block. I was already sold, I don't work by 10 o'clock. Too deep in the streets, felt it, baby, the meant a lot. When that hush comes, know what I gotta do. I'm moving with a two, I paid it out of four. Tell me what I gotta do. Pull up in a bucket, cool. One for me and one for you.